then obviously the student would not be able to participate in the education for that matter, right? Second, I'll tell you the story that one of our educators told when we were discussing these innovative ideas with them. So he said that, sir, during the summer vacation, we are advised, we are told by the government to visit the student's home and ask their parent, meet their parent, and ask them to send their students to school. So when I went, when I say that when I means the educator that I'm talking about, the educator who shared this innovative idea with us. So the educator said that, sir, when I went to the school, when I went to the home of one of the parents, and I asked him to send your kid to school, he said, why should I send my kid to school? My eldest son is illiterate. He sells vegetable at the corner of the street, and he earns somewhere around 200 to 300 every day. So this son also, I'll set up a food stall somewhere to the another corner of this city or my village. If not 300, he'll make 100 or 150 every day. Why should I send him to school? Teacher said, that sir, I went to another parent and I asked him to send his kid to school. He said that my crops are ready to be cut. It's time when the crops are ripened. Instead of sending my kid to school, I will get him involved with me. He will work with me in my farm, in my field, so that we could earn some money out of it. Teacher said that that day I realized that if I want the involvement of my students towards the school, I necessary or I should definitely get the involvement of parent first. If the parent will be involved in the school, definitely the student will automatically will involved in the school. And for the same reason, the teachers said, the innovators said, that we came up with the different ideas how to get the involvement or the participation of the community or of the parents to the school. So I would be discussing the ideas shared by different innovators and the ideas that we clubbed in this case study called community participation. So I would be discussing ideas one by one. Before that, when I would be discussing the ideas, if you have any question in your mind, I would request you to please note down those questions. At the end of the session, I would be giving you a time. And there, you could ask me the question. If you won't write it down, you will forget the question that you will be having in your mind. I would definitely try to not leave a scope for the question. But if in case you have any question, I would really appreciate if you could ask the question. So, talking about the first innovative idea that we would be discussing today would be Supermom. What is Supermom and why this idea came into the mind? The teacher said that, sir, in my school, there was no attendance. In a strength of 25 to 30 students, there were hardly 14 or 10 students in my class. In my school. So I thought how to get the parent involved in this. If the parent would be interested, they definitely would send their child to school. So teacher said this, sir, I came up with an idea. I announced that the student with the highest percentage of attendance within the month, his or her mom will be awarded as super mom in front of everyone during the parent-teacher meeting. So one of the kids, Rahul, he came to the school and he had attendance percentage of 95. So his mother was called during the parent-teacher meeting to be rewarded and recognized in front of all the parents, teachers, and the students. Just keep yourself in place of that mom, the lady who have never been to school or would have hardly been to school for class till class third or fourth standard. Who was deprived of respect each and everywhere, considered second class citizen. The same lady, when in front of teachers, in front of students, in front of villagers and the other parents of the student, when she, if nothing much, if is rewarded with only as a letter of certificate, appreciation, that Mrs. So-and-so has been rewarded for the tremendous work that she is doing, and she is rewarded as the superwoman of this month. Just think about that lady. How she will feel now. She must be, or she will be at the cloud nine now. And other ladies, other parents who are sitting there, don't you think they would also develop that competition in their mind, and they also would want, because nobody in this world, there is no one who don't want to be admired, who don't want to be recognized. Everybody want to be admired. Everyone want to be appreciated. Everybody want to be recognized. So teachers itself definitely took a time, but after a few months, the percentage of attendance in my school, in my class, automatically got increased. Because now the parents' benefit got involved in the school. They wanted to be, they wanted to be appreciated. They wanted to be recognized. They wanted to be awarded. And for the same reason, they started sending their kids, their child, to the schools. Second innovative idea that we would be discussing about would be daughter's school. This idea has been shared by one of our innovators, and she told a story with that. She said that, sir, in our country, number of places, parents somehow will send their male child to the school. But when it comes to the female child, the girl child, they'll stop sending her to the school. So, she said that in my school, we had two kids, Rinky and Pinky. She said that these were two beautiful female child, girl child, and they were very good at study. Their mom also often used to come to drop them to the school, and every time she will ask about how her daughters are doing in the academy. Teacher said that, sir, since she was very much focused towards the studies of the student, and since we don't find these kind of parents, especially when we talk about government school, we don't find involved like this, or who are concerned like this towards the education of their kids. So we started having a discussion, conversation. So during the conversation, the ma'am said that this lady told her that she is pregnant now, and her husband and in-laws have threatened her that this time also there would be a girl child. They are going to kill the mother and the child. Few months passed. The teacher forgot about all these things. Suddenly, Rinky and Pinky, those two beautiful daughters, beautiful girls of class third, they stopped coming to school. The girls were very studious. Both the girls were very studious. And they often never missed the school or class. So teacher got concerned, and she asked one of her colleagues that what happened? Why Rinky and Pinky are not coming to school? So the girl said that, ma'am, don't you know? There is a small baby girl came at their home. Teacher said that, sir, at that point of time, the whole thought came into my mind. The picture started running in my mind. And I recalled everything what these girls' mother told her. she said that the thought was haunting my mind that what their in-laws and husband, what the in-laws and husband of that women told to the teacher. She said, I got in touch with the sarpanch of our village. We made an arrangement that after the school hours, we will make a rally and then we will visit the house of Rinki and me. So teacher said that we got that dhol and all, we had thalis, we started beating dhol and we went to the place of that lady and we started singing or raising slogans that Mubarak ho ghar mein beti aayi hai, badhai ho ghar mein beti aayi hai. That is, congratulations, there is a girl born or goddess Lakshmi born at the home. When teacher said that, sir, when we reached there, there was no happiness at all at the face of any of the parents or the in-laws or the guardians. Teacher said that, sir, we didn't even realize that there was someone born. It was like there was a death at this home. Teacher said that, sir, we met the in-laws of Pinky's and Pinky's mother. We told them that girls are nowhere lesser than a boy. Everything what a boy can do, what a male child could do, a girl child could also do. Talk about Kalpana Chawla. Talk about Indira Gandhi, etc. So, what a girl child, boy child could do, the same thing could be done by a girl child also. The same time. There's no difference. And you never know, these girl child will make you proud someday. Teacher said that we had a discussion with them. We also told them that government is doing so much for the girl child these days. There are a number of schemes running. All you have to do is, you just have to raise them properly, send them to school, and we took the promise from them that when this girl child will reach the year of 3.5 years or 4 years, you will be sending this girl to our school. Teacher said that, sir, after that, we made it a kind of ritual that every time in our village, when a girl is born, I'll go along with the students and the members from the community. We'll go to the house of that, to those parents. We'll congratulate them. And when I met her, that innovative teacher during 2019, she was saying, that said, now the dynamics have entirely been changed. There are a number of girls from our village, our community, who are going to city for higher education, for class 10th, class 12th. So this is how it is. Just a thought can bring a big change. You can never ever think of. And you cannot assume how a small effort would lead to make a huge change. So I would definitely request you all also, let's do something for our society at the same time. The next innovative idea that I would be discussing is tree plantation. We all know how much plants and trees are important for us, for our survival. And if this habit of understanding the importance of tree is told to the students, told to the kids since their childhood, they definitely will understand the importance of plants and trees. There is one more thing. Teachers said that, sir, in our area, in our community, in our village, there are a number of areas, there are a number of people who do not celebrate the birthday of their kids. We wanted to use this day of the birthday of the kids, of the students, for tree plantation. So what we started doing is that we asked the student, we had a record of the student whose birthday fell on which day of the month. At the end of the month, or the last Saturday of the month, we will involve all the students whose birthday fall in that specific month. We'll get in touch with the parents of the student. We'll inform them in prior notice that there would be a birthday celebration on this day. Please attend the birthday celebration of your kid, your child. So just assume of the parent who themselves are not very much capable of celebrating the birthday, or even if they are capable, imagine how would you feel when your daughter or your kids or your boy's birthday would be celebrated by some other people. They would be celebrating the birthday of your kid. Obviously, you'd feel proud, right? So that is what the parent also felt. When the parent reached the school, they are welcomed by their own kid and fellow student. And with the help of kids and the parent, the teacher will plant the sapling. The student is told that now this plant is yours. You could give any name to this plant that you want to give, or you could give your own name to this plant. The way you will, your age will increase. Similarly, the age of this plant will also increase. Next year, when your birthday will fall, we will celebrate the birthday of your plant at the same time. And remember, it's your duty, your responsibility to take care of this sapling. The same kids, assume Raju, the same kid who used to pluck out the plant, pluck out the flower from the plug and pluck out the sapling from the root. Do you think now he would be doing the same thing, plugging out the saplings? No, he won't. Because now he understands the importance of the plant. And he will realize, he will automatically, when he has planted that sapling, he is taking care of the sapling and that plant. Automatically, he will be emotionally attached to that plant. So, at this where teacher made the climate or make the environment green by planting saplings with the help of other students during their birthday. The students also are now enable or now are able to understand the importance of planting or plantation for the environment. At the same time, parents are also involved towards the school. Now they would feel much more related, much more attached to the school at the same time. Isn't it? So the next innovative idea that we would be discussing is superstition, not science. In our country, there are a number of superstitions. And not only in our country, in the world also, there are a number of people who are superstitious about it. Especially when we talk about rural India, there are a number of places. People still are believing in those superstitions. They will talk about ghosts, how to get rid of the ghosts with the ojha and whatever they call them. They'll get in touch with those babas who make a fool of them. Teachers said that, sir, in our area also, number of people get trapped by these fake babas. They'll come, they'll stand at the home in front of the gate, and then they'll say that your home, your house is haunted by some evil spirit. And then they'll cut a layman. The layman will turn red. And they'll say, look, this is the blood. Your house is haunted. All you have to do is give me 1100 bucks. I'll go to a graveyard. I'll do some kind of mantras or whatever I'll be doing. And your house will get rid of all these evil spirits. And they'll snatch the hard-earned money. They will loot the hard-earned money of that person and will run. Teachers said this in our area also. There are a number of places. There would be, there was a tree. People used to think that this tree is haunted. So after 6 p.m., they won't go to that area. Teachers said that, sir, I wanted to make my community get rid of all these things. And for the same reason, during a parent-teacher meeting, I organized a chaupal. I involved all the parents and the members of the village, of the community. I invited them. And I told them that there is a girl in our school, Punya, who has got superpowers and she could do magic tricks. So everybody got curious to know how, what kind of powers Munya has got. In the middle of the day, when everybody was involved in during parent-teacher meeting, teacher announced that Munya is now going to cut the leaven and then the leaven will turn red. Munya did the same thing. She was a class whip and she basically cut the leaven turned red. Everybody got shocked and say, then they start saying that Munya is a goddess, he has got superpower and all. Teacher said that no, there is nothing as such. Munya is not a goddess, he hasn't got any superpower. It's just a science. What we did, I'll just give you a simple example. You know jackfruit? When you will cut the jackfruit, don't wash that knife. Use the same knife and cut a lemon. With the chemical reaction, the lemon will now turn red, which will make it aware that it's a blood. Similarly, if you will see the coconut, there will be some people who will break the coconut and there will be flower inside. And the people will be like, wow, God is very much happy with us. There is a flower inside the coconut. What they do is, this is also not the super, this is also superstition. What they do is, if you will see the coconut closely, there are three holes at the top. Out of these three holes, one hole is quite weaker. It's weak. So it's quite weak. When you press with an instrument, a screwdriver or things like that, it will break. And what they'll do is they'll insert the mogra bud inside, or the marigold bud inside, or the rose bud inside. And after a day or two, since it gets water and all the necessary thing to blossom, when they'll break that coconut, you will see the flower inside. So this is all superstition. Teachers said that I informed the members of the village that this is mere superstition. This is just a superstition. There is a science behind it. You should get rid of it. Don't get involved in all these things. You should get rid of it. Teacher said that now there is an awareness raised within the community, and now the parents are much more aware that what is real, what is science, and what is just a superstition. I hope you like these innovative ideas that we are discussing right now. I'm telling a story with all these innovative ideas so that you could make a clear picture with that, what would have been the story or the idea behind the mind of the teacher, and you could come with your thought process, which will give you a new idea in your mind. The next innovative idea that we would be discussing is adult education. So with adult education, teachers said that, sir, I'm sure you must have also heard about a government scheme called Prashiksha or Each One Teach One. Teacher said that what I do, there are a number of parents who are illiterate, who are not educated. I thought, why not to involve these kids within the education? And I gave the responsibility to my student that when you go to your home, all you have to do is take a time for an hour or two, ask your parent, your mom and your dad, make them sit with you and try to teach them. And there is a psychological reason for that. First, the same parent who is not ill-educated, when he sees that his kid is teaching them, they will feel filled with a sense of pride within them. Second thing, a student, suppose when you are reading something for yourself, you won't pay much heed to whatever you are reading. But when you have to teach it to someone else, you will be more dedicated, more focused, more concerned, because you are about to teach it to someone, and or he and she might ask you the question about that, right? So you would much more focused when you have to teach it to someone. So the student would be more focused. The parent would be more interested. Similarly, then the parent will know that teacher have given this assignment, the task to the student. They would also feel much more closely related to the student. And fourth, they will also understand the importance of education. The next innovative idea that we would be discussing is government schemes. I'll tell you the story with that. What is the story behind this innovative idea? Teacher said that, sir, in our community, there are a number of parents who don't understand the importance of education. And I'm sure number of you will also relate to it. That teacher said that, sir, during parent-teacher meeting, I send the messages to the parent. I told the students that to inform their parent that there will be a meeting at this day. I personally visited few of the parents and asked them to come to the school. In my school, there's a strength of 60 students. Out of those 60 students, when the meeting was, when the parent-teacher meeting was arranged, only two parents turned out at that meeting. So teacher said, sir, that this time, instead of discussing them about the studies of their kids, I discussed about their lives, what they do in their life and how they are doing it. So he said that one of the parents, whose name was Kalu, teacher said that I had a discussion with him. I asked him what he does. So he said that I make the buildings. So teacher said that in our village, there is not much work to do. So how do you manage to get work? So he said that, sir, I visit a city every day in the morning. I'll go to the city, which is 10 to 12 kilometers far from our village. And there I'll stand at the square and we get the work from there. So teacher said that, how do you go? Do you go by bus or auto, etc.? He said, sir, we do not earn that money. If I'll spend 40, 50 rupees every day in the bus or auto, what will I get? So teacher said, what you do then? You use cycle, bicycle to go. He said that, sir, I am planning to buy a bicycle. But every time I'll gather, I'll collect some money, there would be a situation where I will have to spend the money whatever I have collected so far. For example, this time my wife's sister got married, so I gave her anklets. 2 months back, my son got ill, so he had malaria, so we spent 1400 amount on that for his treatment. So every time I'll plan to buy the bicycle, this or spend that money. Teacher said that, sir, I informed him, because at that point of time, government of Uttar Pradesh was running a scheme where they were giving free bicycles to the people below the below poverty line. I told him the same thing, that why are you getting upset? Your name is under BPL quota. Government is giving free bicycle. All you have to do is you need to go to the block office, get the form from there, fill it up. Submit it, you will get your bicycle. So Kalu said that, sir, I am illiterate. I couldn't try it. So how would I be able to do that? Teacher said, okay, not a problem. Go to the block, get the form from there. I'll help you fill the form. I'll fill the form for you. You'll just have to make your thumb impression and then you will get the bicycle. So Kalu did the same thing. After 1.5 to 2 months, he got his cycle. And what do you think? Everywhere, wherever he goes, what do you say? Who gave help? Who helped him get the cycle? गवर्नमेंट और द टीचर डेफिनेटली टीचर सो कल्लू इन एवरीवेयर कल्लू एवरी टाइम एवरी प्लेस whoever asked him from where did you get cycle he said that those masters have got the cycle arranged for me here in the cycle form so in entire village there was a rumor everybody started talking about that the master sir or the teacher is helping the people to get the cycle and in order to get the bicycle people started turning towards the teacher teacher said sir first time there were two parent at the parent teacher meeting gradually the number gets started or the number started increasing I'll tell about different government schemes to the school to the parents like beti bachao beti padhao yojana ladli lakshmi yojana kisan fasal yojana free cylinder gas cylinder scheme etc so teacher said that sir, since the parents started getting benefited out of it they started sending their wards to school first and they also started getting involved in the parent teacher said that, sir during this time when there was a meeting this times when we had a good count I didn't tell anyone about any of the scheme instead I asked them a question that what do you think why am I able to tell you about the different government schemes those are running by the government so the people from the village said that sir since you are a teacher that's why you are able to tell us about all these so teacher asked them what do you think why am I a teacher so they said that sir since you are educated which is an absolute That's what my point is. I am able to tell you about all the government schemes, not because I am a teacher, but because I am educated. If you really want your kids, your children, not to be dependent the way you are dependent on me or any other else, if you do not want them to be deprived of the schemes that are running by that government are running, government is running. If you want them. To be able to live a better life if you want them to be capable of earning bread and butter for them in a much better way than you are earning so for that you will have to start sending your kids teacher said that sir this helped the parent realize the importance of education and they started sending their kids first second the parents also started getting involved completely at the parent teacher meeting and they are much more focused towards the learning of their kids so these are the innovative ideas from the Uttar Pradesh one booklet which you could download from JIIEI website which is www.jiiei.com from there you could download the book if you have any innovative idea which you think you could share with us which you think are which you think fulfills all four requirements that we have I would really appreciate if you could send these innovative ideas to us and you could get a chance to win the reward and recognition at national level so what you have to do is you will have to fill up the form you could either go to www.jiiei.com you will see a pop up there click on the pop up and submit your idea or you could directly go to www.isf which stands for I for idea s for submission f for form .jiiei.com and submit your idea these are all the innovative ideas that I have discussed with you for today if you have any question please feel free to ask me the question you could ask me the question right over from the Zoom or from the
Hello sir we have one question from Facebook mm-hmm. So the question is when will next innovation concept competition sir please declare the dates
okay so sir
ma'am so her name is Deepti Bisht
okay Deepti ma'am hello So I'm glad that you are interested for the competition. I would like to tell you that you could submit your ideas. We are in the world of taking the ideas from the teacher. It's a lengthy process. First, we take the ideas from the teachers, from our educators. Then these ideas, we have a jury who go through all these ideas to ensure that these ideas fulfill all the four requirements that we have. I'm sure you are aware of these conditions. If you are not aware, you could go to our other videos and you can check the details from there. Then once the collection of these ideas are done, then we come up with the date. Right now we do not have the exact date, but the process of submitting the idea and selection of ideas is already going on. So I would appreciate if you could submit the ideas. Right. But the yearly innovative ideas campaign that we run, the award and recognition program that we run, usually is done during the month of March. And if you are a private tutor, if you are from CBSE or ICSE or the other coaching institutes, you could submit your ideas. We also have teacher innovation awards that we also do during the months of September and October that we did last time. There are high chances that we would be doing this in this year, but as of now we do not have the exact details of the dates so far. Thank you so much. Any other question that you would love to ask, please feel free to ask them.
Yes, we have one more question, that is, should every post now be related to COVID-19? And this question is given by Subarta Datta.
No, there is nothing as such. There all the innovative ideas that you would be sharing should be or need to be related with the COVID-19. There is nothing as such. But you know, this pandemic called COVID-19 has entirely changed the dynamics of the training. So the reason we asked you for the ideas related to COVID-19, there are two reasons behind it. First, since you are a teacher, you do number of new things on each and every on a daily basis. So we are sure that from March to now, you definitely have came up with some innovative techniques, and there would be some innovative ideas that you have developed within these 4-5 months. So if you have those ideas, we could appreciate if you could give us those ideas related to the COVID-19 thing to get rid of that, or how we could teach to the students even in these course, even in the situation like this. Other than that, if you have any other idea which you think are benefited for the students or the teachers or the parents or the school or the community or for everyone, please feel free to share those ideas. We would love to read those ideas from you, and we will definitely try to get in touch back if those ideas are really, if those ideas really matches our condition. Thank you.
Okay. So, sir, we have one more question. The question is given by Neha Abrol. So, she is asking, how are the ZIEI ideas being used now as teachers are not taking classes in schools?
Okay. So, the question is asked by?
Neha Abrol.
Okay. Neha ma'am, since you are aware that there are, due to this pandemic, ZIEI ideas are not getting implemented by the trainers at the school, but at the same time there are online classes going on. So in the online classes, teacher could definitely use some of the ideas. They could get the involvement of the community, they could get the involvement of the parents, and they could give the homework as a task that I'm sure if you have seen my other videos where we talked about or we spoke about new age teaching technique, those ideas could easily be used. Sitting at home, teacher could use those ideas and ZIEI ideas could be implemented. At the same time, you're also taking the ideas from the teachers to get their ideas, and then we could share those ideas with the teachers. Thank you so much. Jagat, any other question that we have?
No, not now.
Okay. Thank you so much, everyone. This is Dhirendra Gautam signing off. Namaste.